Today we're going to be looking at how to create an MLA formatted essay. I recommend that you save this document as a template so you can use it for your classes later. That way you don't have to worry about whether or not it's set up properly. You can just check to see that everything's done correctly and not worry about going through all of this again and again and again. First of all, you want to take a look at the page layout. Let's go ahead and click here. Just want to check our margins and make sure that they're set correctly. In the top left corner, you'll see the adjust margins. Click here and just make sure those are normal, 1 inch all the way around. Back on the Home tab, we want to make sure that we select a neutral true type font. Most teachers prefer that you use the Times New Roman font. We also want to make sure that this is set to a standard 12 point. And this just makes sure that your text is easily readable, the right size on the page. We're almost done already, believe it or not. Just a couple more things. We want to click on the paragraph, line, and paragraph spacing block here. And when you click this, just make sure that you select 2.0. This will double space your paper throughout. And before you type anything, click it one more time and see if either of these two bits of text at the bottom say remove. If they do, go ahead and click remove space. And what this will do will prevent Word from creating unnecessary gaps between your paragraphs as you type. Finally, we want to insert a page number. So let's go back to the top, click Insert, and come all the way over to Header and Footer. We're going to click Page Number and then just mouse over top of page down to plain number 3. Now, let's type our last name. Hit the spacebar one time. MLA doesn't specify whether or not you should include a page number on the first page. It actually leaves this decision up to the individual instructor. If your teacher prefers that you have page numbers on the first page, then all you have to do is click Close Header and Footer. If they'd like for you to remove the page number from page number 1, then simply select Different First Page and away it goes. It will, however, continue on pages 2 and following. Then simply click Close Header and Footer. Now it's time to type. The first thing you're going to want to do is type your first and last name. Hit Enter. You're going to type in the name of your class, preferably with the class number as well. For example, English 111. Then you're going to type in your teacher's name. If your teacher has a title such as doctor, you may want to include that as well. Finally, you're going to type in the date, but we're going to do this in a specific format so that it matches any dates we use on our Works Cited page, which we'll cover in a different video. Today is March the 10th, 2015, so we're going to simply type 10 MAR period, or you may go ahead and type March 2015, and then hit Enter again. The next thing that we'll add will be our title, which we will center. Hit Enter one more time, and then make sure that you remember to left align your paper. Notice that we didn't change the formatting of the title. MLA specifies that all of the text be of the same font, the same size, the same color. No need for flashy titles here. We're far more interested in the content of your paper than we are in the flashiness of your title. Don't forget to indent the first line of every paragraph that you type. And you can do that by simply hitting the Tab key. And that's it. Your MLA formatted essay is all set up and good to go. I recommend that you save this as a template, which you can do from the File and use the Save As option, and simply select Microsoft Word Template. That way, when you come back, you don't have to worry about whether or not this is set up properly. Don't forget to check back in our next video when we talk about how to set up an MLA Works Cited page.